Hello, Bezos Bhavish. In my last video, I said that the value of oil was -$34, and the big charts also said that it was valued at -$34. But was the price of oil really -$34, or was it just smart manipulations of the market? Let us find out in this video. The truth is, oil prices weren't actually negative. Technically, the value was negative, but not the price. Big oil companies are not stupid. They are cunning and they will not allow any loss to occur. We can understand this by understanding how the oil market works. To understand how the oil market works, we can use a simple analogy using a guava. Pretend guavas are super important to every person in the society. Every person wants guava. So every day they go to the market and find sellers who are willing to sell guavas. And every seller has a different price. And if you want to buy large quantities of guava, the daily price or the spot price of the guava might fluctuate randomly. Like today it might be 21 rupees, tomorrow it can become 22 rupees. So this is not good for the farmers who do not know how many guavas to harvest several months in the future. And they should also start working from today so that they can plan their harvest in future. And this uncertainty is not beneficial for the buyers nor the farmers. The buyers want a steady supply of guavas. So just because the prices of the guava goes low one day, the farmer might also decide, okay, I might not sell it. And due to all this confusion and uncertainty, the market does not perform efficiently. Now, only if there was a way for the farmers and the sellers to cooperate and plan, and there is a way. So what happens is, the buyer calls the farmer and says, yo bro, I want 69 kgs of guava on 10th June, is that possible? And then the farmer, the seller can be like, yo bro, I got you, how does 20 rupees per kg sound? The farmer agrees to the quantity of the guava and the buyer agrees to the price of the guava. They shake hands and a deal is made. And now the farmer knows exactly how much to produce in the future, and the buyer, he knows exactly how much money to spend. And this removes the uncertainty from the market to one extent. So now all the people who plan to buy and sell the guavas in the future come together and create a guavas futures market. It's basically an agreement, a contract to buy and sell a certain commodity in the future. Not now, in the future. So now, example time. A person wants to buy 100 kgs of guavas from a farmer at a fixed price after 1 month. The farmer says that he can sell it for 20 rupees per kg. The buyer is happy with the price. The farmer is happy with the quantity. They both are happy. They shake hands and then a contract is made. A futures contract is agreed on. So now we wait for 1 month as the contract's lockout date approaches us. So on the lockout date, after 1 month, the buyer goes to the farmer and the farmer is like, these are the 100 kgs of guava, and the buyer is like, okay, 20 rupees per kg, 20 into 100, that is 2000 rupees, here is 2000 rupees. So the buyer pays the money to the farmer, he takes all the juicy guavas, puts it in his trucks, transports it to his warehouse, has label unload the truck, and all these secondary costs are incurred. Ordinarily, the buyer, he will not care much about the secondary expenses because he's going to resell these juicy guavas and then make a lot of profit. But this is not always the case. So let us rewind a bit. Rewind. Person wants to buy 100 kgs of guavas from a farmer at a fixed price after 1 month. The farmer says that he can sell it for 20 rupees per kg. Both are happy, they shake hands, and then a contract is made. A futures contract is agreed on. But after a while, let us assume that the person is not interested in buying the guavas anymore. So instead of cancelling the contract, he can sell that contract to someone else who might be interested to buy the guavas instead. And let us assume the demand rises a little bit and a lot of fluctuations happen and the price is currently 25 rupees per kg. His contract was 20 rupees per kg, price is currently 25 rupees per kg. So our guy, he's like, I don't want the guavas. You have the guavas, take my contract, 25 rupees per kg. give me 2,500 rupees. And then boom, he made a profit of 500 rupees. And a person who bought the futures contract would have to now go to the farmer and take all the guavas, put them in his truck, and he will have to incur the maintenance cost, the label cost, and the lease selling cost and all of that. But if that person manages to sell the guavas for 30 rupees per kg in the market, he makes a profit also. And our original person who sold the contract for 25 rupees per kg, he makes a profit of 5 rupees per kg. But sometimes, instead of the price going from 20 rupees to 25 rupees, it could go from 20 rupees to 15 rupees. And at that time, our man who made the original futures contract, he will have a loss of 5 rupees per kg. Welcome to the stock market. And normally, all this works seamlessly. The consumers have no idea what is happening behind the scenes. Same futures contract happens with coffee, with sugar, with salt, with soybeans, with meat. Now coming back to our example, let us assume that some extreme disaster happened. Suddenly no one wants these guavas. These guavas, shit, these are very bad. No one wants the guavas anymore. So the consumer demand for guava plummets to nearly zero over just a matter of weeks, even though the farmer and buyers have made so many future contracts, so many deals which go out for months and months. Well, now everyone is f***ed. There are a whole bunch of people who are stuck with the futures contract to buy the guavas, who have to now come and pick up the guava, transport it to their warehouse, and all that costs lots of money. And they can't make a profit by reselling the guavas because no one wants the guavas in the market. The demand is zero. The contract holder knows it will be a loss to go through the futures contract. So to get rid of that contract, he goes to that guavas futures market and he says, "So by the way, I have a guavas futures contract, just 20 rupees per kg, anyone wants to buy it?" And all the people laugh at him. They're like, "You idiot, do you think we are idiots? Get lost." And he has to get rid of that contract somehow, you know. And also everyone wants to sell the contract. So a selling war begins. They're like, "Yeah, I'll give you for 15 rupees per kg, just buy it from me." Other person will be like, "No, I'll give you for 10 rupees per kg. And then one genius will come in the market. "Bro, just take the contract from me. I don't need your payment. Gift, bro, gift." And then that person will get two slaps and get shouted at. "We all know the market is down. No one is going to buy guava. Why the hell should we take on the responsibility and incur big losses?" And then all the people who have the contracts, they are in trouble. They're like, "Bro, shit." And they are like, "Okay, listen. You don't pay me, I'll pay you. I'll pay you 5 rupees. Just take the contract from me, please. Even if you pay me 10 rupees, I won't take the contract." They'll be like, "Bro, listen, I will give you $34. Just take the contract, take the obligation of doing the contract." And somehow they make a deal. Because the people who are holding the contract are trying to minimize the losses. They are going to make a loss, obviously. That is confirmed. But they can choose to make a big loss or a small loss. And they are making a small loss by selling it at minus $34. And they have to sell all the contracts before the lockout day, before the contract expires. So they are trying to get rid of the contract as quickly as possible. And that is how the crude oil prices became minus $34. Because people were willing to get rid of their contracts for minus $34. The lockout date for certain oil futures due on May 20 was April 21. And that is why the oil market crashed on April 21. It was just the value of the contract which was minus $34. And that is what the big graph also represented. That does not mean that the price of a barrel was negative. That does not mean that the price of petrol is going to go down. There is plenty of crude oil in storage which can be converted to petroleum. Most of the people might not have minded if they were given $34 and a barrel of oil. What they would have minded is fulfilling all the obligations in the futures contract. That is not something which they wanted to do and incur big losses. And as usual, this video would not have been possible without the Stonks Group. The Stonks Group comprises of Uday, Alavan, Dinesh and me. And if you want to see more videos like this, hit that subscribe button and the bell icon next to it. If you have any doubts, leave a comment down below, hit the like button and I will see you in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.